Penguin Random House Audio presents All of It Is You, Poetry, written and performed by Nico Tortorella.
For you. Introduction. All of it is you. Yes, you, my dear, are all of it. Let it be said, this book has one of the greatest titles of all time. Yeah. When I came up with it, I immediately went on a wild internet chase to see who or where I would be adopting this inclusive, keenly intimate mantra. And to my surprise, no one had used it until now. All of it is you is the you in everything. Everything. This book is the realest work I've ever created. It represents more of me than anything I've put out into the world. What I'm not going to say is that this is the greatest collection of poetry ever written, because it's not. I mean, I would like to think I know where I stand in the lot of legends that came before me and, you know, the genius that walk among. I also know that creating perfection was never my goal. What makes a good poem? What makes a poet great? Is it in the intelligence? Is it in the intellect or the intuition? Is it in how well they can pack fancy words together to create mind-bending syntax? How well they can use metaphor and allegory to paint even the simplest of pictures? Is it in that beatnik typewriter font? Does a poem have to be perfect? And does the poet? Look, I'm going to be the first one to say I am not an expert on anything at all. In fact, quite the opposite. To let you in on a little secret here, my greatest insecurity has always been my own intelligence. Am I smart enough? And even if so, will people care given the shell that holds it? Look, I've exposed myself physically and emotionally in more ways than most people do in a lifetime, but I've never really let the world hold my own complex inner workings quite like this. And let me tell you, I feel very exposed. Okay, the goal for this book and every single day for myself is to be a physical manifestation of process and journey. I strive to live my life in an unconditionally raw, loving, engaging, curious way, and that is exactly how I approached writing. I probed at the subjects, ideas, and theories that get me going, that rile me up on the human experience, and present my interpretation. This book, the most revealing and authentic work I've ever created, rushed out of me almost exactly as you have it. For real. Like, this is me. And to me, even perfection is flawed. I've never written a book before, let alone one of poetry. Rather, I like to believe I live my life in verse. Okay, serious note. I am beginning to understand my own privilege based on gender, what I look like, where I come from, my socioeconomic status, and the color of my skin. What comes with this responsibility is a chance to work even harder to attempt to be a universal voice of understanding for an entire generation. A positive outlook, a positive outlet for a movement, and a source of light. A source of light. and even the darkest of times. All of It Is You was conceived, mapped out, and written in 45 days. Now, I'm not saying this for praise, but rather to let you in on the process. Okay, I split the book into three sections: body, earth, universe. I wanted to start at the beginning, so I began quite literally with the origins of life, inception and birth, and then through the three sections, the poems take you on a journey through human life and connection to the world around us. And finally, to the universe and beyond. And strangely enough, throughout the entire writing process, I never, ever deterred from the original order. I wrote the whole thing in order. You will notice as you listen through this book, the voice evolves. The writing of this book was a transformational journey for me, as I hope, obviously, it will be for you. I mean, that's, to me, that's the practical magic in it. We as human beings on this Earth orb blasting through space at ridiculous speeds are constantly trying to decipher who we are and what our voice is. And if I'm here for anything at all, I am here to remind you it's okay, honorable even, to always, always be a work in progress. Try it all. See what works, what doesn't, and know that all of it is worth celebrating. Because, in fact, all of it is you. I encourage you to listen to this book however you feel inclined. Start at the beginning, go to the end, start at the end, go to the beginning, or, hey, even ask the book a question. Play a random track and listen to what this book has for you. Now, I can't promise that each piece will resonate, but I can promise you that there is real, direct from source alchemy present in every single piece. Now, it's up to all of us, myself included, for real, to put it to use. Before you start, a little note on the cover art. The six-pointed star historically carries a lot of weight. In different parts of the world, the universal shape is referred to as Merkaba. Mer meaning light, ka meaning spirit, and ba meaning body. Light, spirit, body. It is known both as the chariot and the throne of God. It is believed by some to be the very sacred geometry in which all life stems. For mystics around the whole planet, the shape has been used both for ascending and descending to dimensions other than the one that we are all so familiar with. For me, there's a reason, a divine reason, it keeps showing up in my meditations and waking life. Every time I close my eyes, I see it. It is the vehicle that delivers the message as far and wide as it possibly can. So combined with an iteration of Da Vinci's Vitruvian Man, which is based on the exact same shape, my own natal astrology chart, our planet, the cosmos, and my left hand, hopefully there's enough power here to send you and this book everywhere. Because remember, all of it is you. And I love all of it, no matter what. All of you. All of you. sperm. Olympic medaled swimmers, fate meddling, ejaculated. Their pistol shot fired to ocean.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.